So we'll start. We'll continue the yesterday's sum only. In yesterday's sum, we had started with the analysis of the beam B3. So we had done the we had started the analysis of beam B3, and in the analysis of beam B3, we had done the first step. That means we had calculated the load. So we had calculated we had done the loading calculations. So in loading calculations, first of all, we consider the self weight of the beam B3. So the self weight of the beam B3 comes up to be 2.53 kilonewton per meter. Then हमने wall load consider किया था, and also we had considered the load from the slab. So total load हमें मिला था for the beam B3, that is 42 kilonewton per meter. Total load we had got, that is 41.88, that is approximately equals to 42 kilonewton per meter. So after that, as we know that the end reaction for the beam B3 will act as a point load for the beam B7. So up till here we had done in the last lecture. So now proceeding further, we'll do the shear force and bending moment calculations. Then we can calculate the design of the beam B7. So beam 7 के लिए भी हमने ऑलरेडी बीम 7 के लिए भी हमने लोडिंग कैलकुलेशंस तक के कल किया था. वी हैड कंप्लीटेड द बीम B3 एंड वी हैड स्टार्टेड द बीम B7 एज वेल एज वी हैड डन दिस लोडिंग कैलकुलेशंस फॉर द बीम B7. सो बीम 7 के लिए हमें लोड कितना मिला था? बीम 7 के लिए वी हैड गॉट द टोटल लोड, दैट इज WU की वैल्यू हमें कितनी मिली थी? 60 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर. हियर देयर शुड बी मीटर नॉट मीटर स्क्वायर. So 60 kilo newton per meter, and the point load we had got, that is 63 kilo newton for the beam B7. Okay, so beam B7 ke liye I will explain you this once again. So beam B7 ke liye humne width of beam kitna liya hai? Width of beam we had considered it as 300 mm. Then depth we are going to consider. Depth के लिए हम लोग हमेशा क्या लेते हैं? Span by 10. तो हमारा total span for the beam B7 कितना है? 8 meter, that is 8000 mm. So span by 10 will comes up to be 800. So the depth of beam is as 750. So we have taken the 750, not 800, because हमने 800 क्यों नहीं कंसिडर किया? अगर हम 800 कंसिडर करते थे, व्हेनेवर द डेप्थ इज ग्रेटर देन 750, वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड द साइड रेनफोर्समेंट आल्सो. सो इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड द साइड रेनफोर्समेंट, हमने डेप्थ कितनी कंसिडर की है? वी हैड कंसिडर द डेप्थ ऑफ बीम एज 750 ओनली, सो दैट वी डोंट हैव टू प्रोवाइड द साइड रेनफोर्समेंट. एडिशनल साइड रेनफोर्समेंट वी डोंट नीड टू प्रोवाइड, दैट्स व्हाई वी हैड कंसिडर द डेप्थ ऑफ बीम एज 750. Then proceeding for the calculation of load. So सबसे पहले self weight calculate करोगे, that is B into D. तो B कितना है? 300 mm. मीटर में convert किया तो 0.3. Then depth we had considered, that is 750. So 750, that is 0.75 into density, that is 25 into 1.5. Directly we are going to multiply over here. So self weight हमें मिलता है 8.43 किलो न्यूटन पर meter. Then after calculating the self weight, we need to calculate the wall load. So wall load calculate करने के लिए, again wall load के लिए हमें thickness दी थी question में, that is, so that thickness we are going to consider over here. So 0.115 into 3 into again density into 1.5, we will get the wall load, that is 10.35. Now see your earlier steps. Earlier steps में हमने load कितना calculate किया था? S2 के लिए हमें load कितना मिला था? 14.5. So 14.5, that is W into total load for the S2. S2 के लिए हमें load कितना मिला था? 14.5. So 14.5 S2 का span कितना है? Total span on which your S2 is being acting, that is 3. You are having the PDFs with you, so you can just go through the plan. So see the plan. So in that plan, the total span on which your slab S2 is acting, that is of the 3 meter. That's why we are going to consider it as 3. So it is 3 by 2 in bracket 1 minus 1 upon again 3 into 4 by 2. 4 is your vertical distance for the slab S2. और हमने स्क्वायर क्यों किया? बिकॉज स्लैब एस टू हमारा दो जगह पे एक्ट हो रहा है, इसलिए वी हैड डन द स्क्वायर, दैट इज 4/2 स्क्वायर. सो हमें लोड फ्रॉम द स्लैब एस टू कितना मिलता है? 17.65, दैट इज वी हैड कंसीडर द लोड फ्रॉम द स्लैब एस टू. अभी एस थ्री का जो स्लैब है दैट वी नीड टू कंसीडर. सो एस थ्री के लिए देखो, अगेन एस थ्री के लिए जो आपको लोड मिला था फॉर द स्लैब एस थ्री, so the load is 15.5. again S3 कितने span पे act हो रहा है? again S3 is acting on the span 3 meter, so that is W into L by 2, so it is 3/2. so load from the S3 मिलता है हमें 23.25. so like this after adding total load comes up to be 59.68 kilonewton per meter. That is approximately equals to 60 kilonewton per meter. There is it should be per meter. And again, point load from the beam B3 will be 63 kilonewton. So in this way, we have done the loading calculations. Now proceeding further for the shear force and the bending moment calculations. I hope everyone understood up till here. Everyone understood these loading calculations. Yes, clear up till here. Okay. Now proceeding for the shear force and the bending moment calculations. So bending moment and shear force, as you have considered, आपका load कितना आया है? Total 60 kilonewton per meter. और point load आपको मिला है 63 kilonewton from the beam B3. तो उसपे से you need to calculate the moment. सो मोमेंट कैलकुलेट करने के लिए अगेन डब्ल्यू एल स्क्वायर बाई 8 प्लस डब्ल्यू एल बाई 4, दैट मोमेंट आपको मिलता है 606 किलो न्यूटन मीटर एंड द शियर फोर्स इज 271.5 किलो न्यूटन. एंड आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग द शियर फोर्स एंड बेंडिंग मोमेंट, यू नीड टू चेक वेदर द बीम इज सिंगली रेनफोर्स्ड और द डबली रेनफोर्स्ड. Now you need to check whether your beam B7 is singly or doubly. So उसके लिए you need to assume the cover. अब cover कितनी assume करोगे? 60 meter safer side. You will take the effective cover as you can take 50 also or 60 also. 50 to 60 mm cover you can consider. Then moment of resistance. As you know, the formula to calculate the moment of resistance is 0.138 into BD square FCK. So as the grade of concrete is 20, so FCK is 20, B is your 300, or depth आपकी कितनी थी? Depth आपने 750 provide की थी, तो 750 minus cover that is 60, तो आपको कितना मिलता है depth? That is 690. 750 minus 60, you will get the depth as 690 square. इसमें से आपको मोमेंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस मिलेगा 394.21 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. सो इट इज लेस देन द मोमेंट एक्टिंग. मोमेंट एक्टिंग यू हैड गॉट, दैट इज 606 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. सो इट इज लेस देन दैट वैल्यू. सो हियर द योर सेक्शन इज डबली रेनफोर्स सेक्शन. देन प्रोसीडिंग फर्दर, नाउ यू नीड टू do the calculation for the longitudinal reinforcement. Yes, anyone is having any doubt up till step number 3? I hope everyone understood up till here. Kisi ko kuch doubt hai? If you are having any of the doubts up till step number 3, you can ask. Okay. So now for the step number 4, you need to calculate the longitudinal reinforcement. So for calculation of longitudinal reinforcement, again you are having the formula, that is MR will be equals to C1 into L11, same formula that you had used in the last sum also, plus C2 into L into A2. Again, 606 into 10 raised to power 6, substitute the value for the moment, then substitute all the values plus FSC into ASC into D minus D dash. You need to calculate. V394 is the value for the moment of resistance. You need to convert it in. Aapko mm mein answer chahiye, isliye multiplied it by 10 raised to power 6. Now you need to calculate ASC. So before calculating ASC, first of all you need to calculate FSC. So again, for calculation of FSC, you are having the formula, that is 700 into 1 minus D dash by XU max. Again, you are assuming the value for the D dash as 50. So XU max ke liye aapke paas mein formula hai 0.48 into D. D इफेक्टिव कवर माइनस करने के बाद डी की वैल्यू आपको कितनी मिलती है, दैट इज 690. यू आर गोइंग टू गेट द वैल्यू फॉर डी एज 690. सो सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ डी ओवर हियर, दैट इज 0.48 इनटू डी. देन यू विल गेट एफएससी, दैट इज 594.32 मेगा पास्कल. सो बट मिनिमम वैल्यू फॉर द एफएससी इज 350 मेगा पास्कल. सो वी आर गोइंग टू कंसीडर द मिनिमम वैल्यू फॉर द एफएससी, that is 350. अगर 350 से कम आती थी तो we are going to consider that value whatever the it is coming in your answer. But अभी आपकी 350 से ज्यादा आई है, so that's why we are going to consider the minimum value, that is 350. Now you need to calculate the ASC. So just substitute all the values in the above formula and calculate the value of ASC. Moment of resistance, moment, that is 606 into 10 raised to power 6. Then this moment of resistance, that is 394.21 into 10 raised to power 6. FSC, just now you had calculated. So FSC aapko kitna mila? 350. Then into ASC, D kitna hai? Depth 690 minus D dash, you had assumed it as 50. So ispe se aapko area ki value milti hai 944.01 mm square. Then after calculating ASC, you have to provide 2 bar of 25 mm file at the top. So by this you can conclude this, that you have to provide 2 bars of 25 mm file at the top. Then again you need to calculate AST. So for calculation of AST, you will consider compression will be equal to tension. So for that again you are having this formula, that is 0.36 into FCK into B into XU max plus FSC into ASC will be equals to 0.87 FY into AST. Abhi FCK is again 20, B is 300, XU max you had calculated, that is 331.2, FSC apne consider kiya hai 350, ASC just now you had calculated, that is 944.01. और FY कितना है, ग्रेड इज गिवन टू यू, दैट इज 415. सो इनटू 415 इनटू एएसटी. सो आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल दिस कैलकुलेशंस, एएसटी आपको मिलता है 2896.53 mm square. सो आफ्टर दिस यू नीड टू सी which mm diameter bars you need to provide. So you need to provide 3 bars of 25 mm diameter plus 3 bars of 25 mm diameter at the bottom. So depth of main beam is greater than the depth of secondary beam, so B2 will be always greater than the B7. So you are done with the longitudinal reinforcement. Now proceeding for the next step, that is check for shear. So anyone is having any of the query up till here in this in the last step, that is in the step number 5 for the longitudinal reinforcement? If you are having any of the doubts in the step 4 and 5, you can ask. Hope everyone understood up till here. Yes, Tanveer, Swati, understood up till here? Any queries? नाउ वी नीड टू चेक फॉर द शियर. तो शियर चेक करने के लिए अगेन यू आर हैविंग द फॉर्मूला दैट इज टाउ वी विल बी इक्वल्स टू वीयू बाय बीडी. सो शियर फोर्स आपको मिला था 271.5. सो एज यू आर कन्वर्टिंग इन एमएम सो इनटू 10 टू पावर 3 अपॉन बी दैट इज 300. डी डेप्थ कितना है 690. तो टाउ भी आपको मिलता है 1.31 मेगा पास्कल. देन यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट द परसेंटेज मिनिमम. सो फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग ऑफ परसेंटेज मिनिमम सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज दैट इज एएसटी अपॉन बीडी इनटू 100. सो एएसटी सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ एएसटी दैट इज 2945.24 अपॉन बीडी इनटू 100. सो मिनिमम परसेंटेज यू हैड गॉट दैट इज 1.42%. Then from the IS code, you need to calculate the value for the tau C. So for calculation of tau C, you need to refer the smaller one value and the bigger one value. So smaller value kitni hai 1.25 and the bigger value is 1.50. So by using the method of interpolation, aapko tau C calculate karna hai for this percentage minimum. So tau C आपको मिलता है 0.704. After calculating tau C, you need to calculate VNS that will be equals to shear force minus tau C into B into D. So इसके लिए आपको वैल्यू मिलती है this 125.77. So you can provide two leg of 8 mm diameter stirrups over here. And after that you need to calculate spacing. Spacing as you know there are four formulas, from that four you have to consider the minimum spacing. So the first formula is 0.87 into fy into asv into d upon vns. So fy aapka kitna hai 415, asv as you are going to take two leg of 8 mm diameter bar, so isliye you are going to multiply it by 2. 8 mm diameter bar le rahe isliye pi by 4 into 8 square. So pi by 4 into 8 square कितना हुआ 64. Then d depth कितना है 690. Then VNS just now you had calculated. So after substituting all the values आपको spacing कितनी मिलती है यहाँ पे? Spacing आपको मिलती है 199.12 meter. Then the next formula to calculate the spacing is 0.87 into fy into asv upon 0.4b. So after substituting all the values, then again fy कितना लोगे 415, asv again 2 into pi by 4 into 64 and b की value is 300. So after substituting all the values, again spacing आपको मिलेगा 302.47 mm. Then the third formula is 0.75d. So 0.75 into D that is 690. So it is 517.5 mm. And the last D not value for the spacing is 300 mm. So from all the four, the minimum value is 199.12. So approximately equals to 175 we are going to consider. So you have to provide two leg of 8 mm pipe at the rate of 175 mm center to center spacing. Now the last check is to check for the deflection. Now we have checked for the shear. We have done the check for the shear. Abhi hame deflection ke liye check karna hai. So for deflection, again you are having the formula on the page number 38 of your IS code 456-2000. So FS ke liye you are having the formula that is 0.58 into FY into AST required upon AST provided. So AST required आपको कितना मिला था 2883.86 and AST provided आपको मिलता है 2945.43. उस पे से FS आपको मिलता है 235.68 मेगा पास्कल. After calculating FS, as you had calculated percentage minimum, so minimum percentage you know that is 1.42. Now from the same IS code, from the page number 38, आपको graph पे से MFT की value लेना है. MFT is nothing but the modification factor. So modification factor you are going to take from the graph. Now for FS 235.68 and for percentage minimum 1.42, आपको MFT की वैल्यू मिलेगी 0.9 मेगा पास्कल. After that, again you need to do the calculations for depth. So depth is L effective upon 20 MFT. So L effective is your 8000 upon 20 into MFT, that is 0.9. So it is 444.44, that is less than 750. So here your design is safe for the deflection. So anyone is having any query in the design of beam B7? Yes, anyone is having any doubt in the beam B7? If you are having any of the query in this design of beam B7, you can ask. Otherwise, we will proceed further for the design of beam B2. Yes, understood? All of you? So we'll start with the design of beam B2. Now we'll start with the design of beam B2. So since the depth of the beam B7 is 750 mm, we will keep the same depth for the beam B2 also. So B2 के लिए भी हम 750 consider करेंगे as we had considered for the beam B7. So the same depth we are going to take for the beam B2 also, and also we are going to consider the width as 300 mm. Now proceeding further for the calculation of loading. So first of all, again we need to calculate the self weight. So self weight calculate करने के लिए b into d into density. Weight कितना है? 300. After converting in meter, हमें कितना मिलेगा? 0.3. Again depth कितना है? 750. So it will be 0.75 into density. Density is 25 into 1.5. So self weight हमें मिलता है 8.44 kilonewton per meter. And same wall load will also be same over here. Now wall load will be 0.115, that is already given in the question, that is thickness of the beam support will be of 115 mm, so convert it in meters, so 0.115 into 3 into 20, density into 1.5, so it will be 10.35 kilonewton per meter. Then you need to consider the load from S2. S2 beam slab ke liye load consider karna hai. So as you know that the total load for the beam B2, see the plan you are having. I hope everyone is having the plan with you. See the plan, B2 kahan pe hai? B2 is exactly below B1. B1 ke niche jo act ho raha hai, that is your beam B2. So for that only we are going to design. So total load kitna act ho raha hai? Total load acting on the slab S2 is 14.5. अभी स्पैन कितना है जिस पे बीम B2 एक्ट हो रहा है? स्पैन इज योर 3 मीटर. स्लैब S2 का जो स्पैन है दैट इज 3 मीटर. सो S2 का ही स्पैन हम कंसीडर करेंगे. स्पैन इज 3/3, सो इट विल बी 14.5 किलोन्यूटन पर मीटर. देन द आफ्टर summation, total load will be 36.9, that is approximately equals to 37 kilonewton per meter. Then you have to consider the S1 also. Now B2 pe S1 bhi act ho raha hai, so you have to consider the load from the S1 also. So we will consider the load jo humne S2 ke liye load consider kiya tha, equal load we are going to consider for the slab S1 too. So the factor load we are going to consider for the slab S1 also. So factor load S1 ke liye kitna act ho raha hai? S1 ke liye factor load is 14.5 only. So S1 ka load bhi hum consider karenge. So 14.5, abhi S1, see again go to your plan. एस वन के लिए स्पैन है आपका 2.5, सो वी आर गोइंग टू टेक 2.5 फॉर द एस वन, सो अपॉन 2, सो इट विल बी 18.125, देन टोटल विल कम्स अप टू बी 51.415, दैट इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली इक्वल्स टू 51.5 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर. As well as we are going to consider the point load for the beam B7, that is 27.5 kilonewton per meter. अभी S2 के लिए 3 से क्यू डिवाइड किया और S1 के लिए 2 से क्यू डिवाइड किया. Yes, can anyone tell me? Why हमने जब slab S2 consider किया, so we are divided by 3, and when we had considered the slab S1, we are divided by 2. Yes, anyone? See your plan. Plan देखने के बाद में आपको समझ में आ जाएगा. Yes, Faraz, can you tell me? Mehfooz. जब हमने S2 का लोड कंसीडर किया, we are divided by 3, that is W into L by 3, और जब S1 का लोड कंसीडर किया, we are divided by 2. Yes.
S2 is... Ma'am, S2 is two-way slab?
Yes, correct. S2 is two-way slab, that's why we are divided by 3, and S1 is one-way slab, so we are divided by 2. Now understood? Yes, Anis, now you understood. Now proceeding further. I hope everyone understood these loading calculations. Now proceeding further, shear force and the bending moment calculations. So moment and shear force and bending moment calculations. So just now we had calculated these all the loads. So substitute the values for the loads. So हमने total load कितना calculate किया था, that is 51.5, that is acting over here on the 3 meter span, और जो दूसरा load था, that is 37 kilonewton meter. Then the point load we are going to consider, it as 271.5 kilonewton. So, उसपे से we are going to calculate the bending moment. So, bending moment हमें मिलता है 606.375 kilonewton meter. So, see in the last sum also you had got the bending moment value. आपको beam B7, जब आपने beam B7 calculate किया था, B7 के लिए आपका जो loading था वो अलग था. B7 के लिए आपको total load कितना मिला था? 60 मिला था. और पॉइंट लोड एक्ट हो रहा था 63 किलो न्यूटन का. सिंस देयर आल्सो आपको मोमेंट की वैल्यू मिली थी 606 किलो न्यूटन मीटर, एंड हियर आल्सो यू हैड गॉट द वैल्यू फॉर मोमेंट एज 606.375 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. सो बेंडिंग मोमेंट एंड द साइज ऑफ द बीम इज सेम एज दैट ऑफ द बी7. सो वी कैन डायरेक्टली टेक द डिजाइन ऑफ द बीम बी7. हमारे बेंडिंग मोमेंट की वैल्यू सेम आई है, इसलिए हम डायरेक्टली जो भी डिजाइन हमने B7 के लिए किया था, वी कैन टेक दैट डिजाइन डायरेक्टली ओवर हियर. सो नो नीड टू डू द कैलकुलेशंस, रिपीट कैलकुलेशंस, नो नीड टू डू ऑल द स्टेप्स. वी विल डायरेक्टली टेक द वैल्यूज फ्रॉम देयर. सो ASC हमें कितना मिला था? वी आर प्रोवाइडेड 2 बार्स ऑफ 25 mm diameter there also, and for AST we are provided the 3 bars of 25 mm diameter and 3 bars of again 25 mm diameter, and shear force will also be same as that we had calculated for the beams B7. So since bending moment and shear force will be approximately equals to the bending moment and shear force for the beam B7, jo humne beam B7 ke liye shear force or bending moment calculation kiya tha, same we are getting in this beam, that is beam B2. So therefore we will provide the same amount of longitudinal reinforcement as well as shear reinforcement in this beam, since the size will also be same. So all the calculations we will are same for the both the beams, for the beam B2 and for the beam B7. So it is easy for you. So no need to do repeat all the steps again. So you can write this note whenever you will solve this sum if you got the bending moment and shear force equal. So everyone understood up till here. Now proceeding for the detailing. If anyone is having any doubts up till here, you can ask. Here we had completed all the designs. Whatever they are asked in the question. In the question, they had asked us to design for the slab S2 and S3, as well as they had told you to design for the beam B7 and B2. So we had completed all the design part. Now proceeding for the detailing one. Before that, if you are having any doubts, you can ask. I hope everyone understood up till here. Yes, understood? Should I proceed?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, but an exam will have to write pura na? Ye sirf note click kar nahi chalega na?
Nahi, likh sakte ho. If agar shear force or bending moment ki value equal aa rahi hai, to you can write this note. No need to repeat That's all okay. the steps again. Yeah.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Okay, now proceeding for the detailing one. See here. UT paper pattern will be quickly shared by you. Most probably in UT there will be half descriptive and the half MCQ. So let's see what happens. So I think we will not give you this much lengthy sum. We will shorten the sum and we will give you. In UT you have to design only for the one beam or only for the one slab. And for staircase also, we'll see what will happen. We will let you know soon. By today, the pattern will be finalized, and after finalizing the pattern, we'll let you know. In next week. Yes, what, Saurabh?
Exam dates probably.
Exam dates probably will be in the next week. The official message will be there in your WhatsApp groups.
Okay.
Probably it will be in the next week only.
Okay.
So here there is a detailing part of this particular sum that you had solved just now. So as you can see, this is the width that is of the 300 mm. This is the depth that is 125. This is the reinforcement that you had calculated, that is 85 at the rate of 325 mm center to center. Then again, here also you had calculated the reinforcement that is of the 85 at the rate of 225 mm center to center. So we have provided the minimum reinforcement in the wire direction. As you can see here, there is your wire direction and you have provided the minimum reinforcement. Then also here the reinforcement is of the 10-5 at the rate of 300 mm center to center. This reinforcement is again 8-5 at the rate of 250 mm center to center. And here jo yahan pe aapne corner mein provide kiya hai, so we have not provided the reinforcement in the wire direction kyunki here there is one way slab, so we can provide two bars. Here we are not provided the reinforcement. We are provided the 10-5 at the rate of 300 mm center to center. And we have taken it because it will halve the reinforcement in the bottom. That is double spacing of the bottom. Double spacing at the bottom is there. So we are provided 10-5 at the rate of 300 mm center to center in this corner. So again, here also we have provided the same reinforcement that is of the 8-5 at the rate of 325 mm center to center. एंड दिस इज दिस वन जस्ट नाउ यू हैड कैलकुलेटेड दैट इज आपने कितना दो बार्स प्रोवाइड किए थे फॉर 25 mm डायमीटर एंड थ्री बार्स फॉर 25 mm डायमीटर एंड थ्री बार्स ऑफ 25 mm डायमीटर एज वेल एज यू हैड प्रोवाइडेड द टू लेग आपकी स्पेसिंग की वैल्यू कितनी आई थी दैट इज 175 mm सेंटर टू सेंटर सो यू हैड प्रोवाइडेड द टू लेग्स ऑफ 85 एट द रेट ऑफ 175 mm सेंटर टू सेंटर एंड सी अगेन आपकी टोटल डेप्थ कितनी थी 750 यू हैड कंसीडर्ड द टोटल डेप्थ एंड द विड्थ यू हैड कंसीडर्ड फॉर द बीम दैट इज 300 एंड अगेन दिस इज ऑल द रेनफोर्समेंट दैट यू हैड कैलकुलेटेड जस्ट नाउ सो यू हैड कैलकुलेटेड टू बार्स ऑफ 25 mm डायमीटर हियर्स यू हैड कैलकुलेटेड द थ्री ऑफ 25 mm डायमीटर प्लस थ्री ऑफ 25 mm डायमीटर एज वेल एज टू लेग स्टिरअप्स ऑफ 85 at the rate of spacing 175 mm center to center so these are all the stirrups so any doubt in this detailing part hope everyone understood the detailing part if you are having any of the query over here you can ask and if we are running short of time last 2 minutes are there so those who are not given the attendance give your attendance in the chat box and rejoin the lecture again after 10 minutes. I hope everyone understood this detailing. Yes, any doubts? If you are having any of the doubts, you can ask. Yes, Vinay, Mehfooz, Omkar, understood. Okay. So here we had completed the flooring system. From next session onwards, we are going to start the retaining wall.